हेलो किड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड 2। किड्स, टेक आउट योर इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक, कम्युनिकेट विद कैम्ब्रिज। पेज नंबर 6। ए, कंप्लीट द टेबल यूजिंग वर्ड्स दैट नेम दिस। किड्स, इन दिस यू हैव टू राइट डाउन द कॉमन नेम इन द मिसिंग बॉक्सेस। सो पीपल, बॉय, गर्ल, टीचर। प्लेसेस, लाइब्रेरी, गार्डन, स्कूल। एनिमल्स, लायन, डॉग, कैट। थिंग्स, पेंसिल, बुक, बॉक्स। बर्ड्स, parrot, crow, sparrow. Students, I have written all the words that belongs to common noun. Now in the next exercise you have to write down the proper noun. B, now complete the table using special naming words. Special naming word means proper noun. Persons, Pawan, Mohan, राम। प्लेसेस, हैदराबाद, अमृतसर, सूरत। डेज, फ्राइडे, मंडे, संडे। नाउ द नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज दैट इज ऑन पेज नंबर 7। रीड व्हाट दिस पीपल आर सेइंग, देन से व्हाट दे डू। अनस्क्रैम्बल द लेटर। Number 1 is already done. Number 2. I catch thieves. I am a dash. Now in the bracket the word are unscrambled. The letters are unscrambled. We have to make a correct word. So now it become police man. Number 3. I look after sick people in a hospital. I am a nurse. Number 4. I fly planes. I am a pilot. Number 5. I write books. I am a dash writer. So kids, now the next exercise, page number 8. Listen to the riddles and complete them. Then guess the answer. The clue are in the picture. Yes, kids, the answer are in the picture itself. We have to find out the answer. Number 1. I am made of dash. I am full of dash. What am I? So, I am made of paper. I am full of pages. What I am? Book. Number 2. I am called the ship of the desert. Who I am? Camel. Yes, kids, you can see the camel in the picture also. Number 3. I float in the sky. I can hide the sun. I bring rain. Who am I? Students, the clue is in the answer is in the picture. Cloud. You can see the cloud? Yes. Number 4. I am dash. I am made of different dash. I am round. I am made of different colors. Children love to play with me. Who am I? Ball. You can see ball in the picture? Yes. Number 5. I have many teeth. I am made of plastic or wood. Who am I? Comb. Yes. Now, kids, Next exercise, that is on page number 9. Work in pair. Use may or can for asking permission in this situation. Now, number 1. You want to borrow a pen from your friend. What will you say? Kids, you want to borrow a pen from your friend. What will you say to your friend? Can I borrow your pen, please? Now, the second situation is you want to go to the library. How will you ask your teacher? What will you say to your teacher? May I go to the library, ma'am? Yes, these answers you have to write down in notebook, in English notebook. B exercise, look at the picture and describe what you see. Kids, you have to see the picture very carefully. And yes, the hint, some words are given. From that words, you have to make a sentence very properly. This is a desert. It is covered with sand. There are huge pyramids. The sky is blue. There are clouds in the sky. There is a palm tree beside the oasis. Children are riding a camel. Both are looking very happy. This answer also you have to write down in English notebook. Now, students, we have already done this of singular to plural. Yes, you know that the rule of making a singular noun to plural. How we make a singular noun to plural, kids? Yes, by adding s or es. A exercise, change this noun from one to many. Number 1, book, books. Number 2, desk, desk. Number 3, bag, bags. Number 4, pencil, pencils. Number 5, chair, chairs. Number 6, pen, pens. Now, in this we have to add ES. Why we are going to add ES? Because at the end of the word there is double S, CH, SH, X and S. Change these nouns from one to many. Number 1, glass, glasses. Number 2, brush, brushes. Number 3, class, classes. Number 4, peach, peaches. Number 5, match, matches. Number 6, fox, foxes. Number 7, bench, benches. Number 8, bus, buses. Now, name one thing that is shaped like this. Number 1, round. Which thing is round in shape? Ball. Number 2, square. Which thing is in square shape? Napkin. Oval, egg. Triangle, slice of pizza. Now, exercise on page number 21. Look at this picture and complete the paragraph. The next morning, Bukka goes out for a walk. How colorful everything looks. He looks at the house with the red roofs, the dash fence, brown fence, the dash grass, green grass, and the dash flowers. Flowers are of which color, kids? White. The sky is dash with fluffy dash clouds. The sky is blue with fluffy white clouds. But best of all is a rainbow in the sky. Kids, you have to color this picture that is on page number 22. Exercise on page number 24. Look at this paragraph describing a hippopotamus. Some words are missing. Fill in the blanks detail using the words from the box. Kids, from the box you have to fill the blanks. The hippopotamus is a dash animal. Huge. Huge means big. It has dark skin, thick dark gray skin. It has dash legs, short legs, and a dash mouth. Very large mouth. It has a dash tail. It has a tiny tail. Tiny means small. Now, the exercise on page number 24. Kids, you have already did this exercise in grammar textbook. Yes. And the answers of this exercise you have to write down in English notebook. Rewrite these sentences correctly. Use capital letters and full stop. Students, you know very well that at the starting of the sentence, beginning of the sentence, the first letter should be capital, and the name, the proper nouns are always in capital form. Number 1. The children in class were well behaved. So what will be the answer? Yes, the first letter, it means T, should be capital. Number 2. Tom is a naughty cat. Tom, T letter should be capital, and at the end of the sentence there should be full stop. Number 3. River Kaveri flows through Karnataka. Now kids, look, the first letter R should be capital, Kaveri K should be capital, and Karnataka K letter should be capital, because Kaveri and Karnataka are proper noun, and in proper noun first letter should be capital. Number 4. My best friend is Nandita. Again, first letter capital, Nandita. Nandita is a name of a girl. Then it should be capital, the first letter N. Number 5. Garima is the captain of the football team. Garima is a name of a girl, so first letter should be capital. Students, hope you have understood this exercise very well. You have to write down all these exercises in your grammar, in your English reader textbook. Bye-bye.